This possibility of Turing machines looping forever leads us to define the notion of a language recognizer. We say that a Turing machine recognizes a language if and only if it accepts every string in the language and does not accept any string not in the language. Thus, we can say that the Turing machine from the quiz does indeed recognize the language consisting of strings that contain a 1. It accepts those containing a 1, and it doesn't accept the others. Instead, it loops on them. Contrast this definition with what it takes for a Turing machine to decide a language. Then it must not only accept every string in the language, but it has to reject every string not in the language. It can't loop like this Turing machine. If we wanted to build the decider for this language, we would need to modify the Turing machine so that it detects the end of the string and moves into the reject state, like so. At this point, it also makes sense to define the language of a machine, which is just the language that the machine recognizes. After all, every machine recognizes some language, even if it's the empty one. Formally, we define L of M to be the set of strings that M accepts. That's the language of the machine M.